The following radio program is for informational purposes only and is neither specific nor tailored financial advice to any individual. It is not intended as an offer or solicitation for the purchase or sale of any financial instrument. Always do your own due diligence and consult a financial advisor before making any investments. Investing involves risk, which can result in the loss of any or all principal. Peter Weitz is a registered investment advisor with Fusion Analytics Investment Partners, LLC, an SEC-registered investment advisor, as well as a registered rep with Fusion Analytics Securities, LLC, a FINRA-registered broker-dealer and SIPC member. All views expressed in this program are those of the host or guests and do not reflect the opinions of Fusion Analytics Investment Partners nor its affiliates. Your investments. How secure are you that they are secure? Do you want to know more about investing, retirement, and moving to the next level in business? Welcome to In Black and Weitz, featuring host Peter Weitz. Our program will answer all of the questions about your future and so much more. It's all about smart business and smarter investing. Now, here is your host, Peter Weitz.
Hi, thanks. Welcome back to the program. I'm your host, Peter Weitz. A big thanks last week to Kevin Lane for interviewing me. I was certainly excited to talk about some of the things that we've got going on and some of the exciting projects we have here in South Florida at Fusion Analytics. I'm actually joined today by another one of our corporate executives and experts. His name is Joseph Fitzgerald, and we're going to get into the show right away, and I'm going to tell you a little bit about Joe. But before I do, there's a couple things that are going to happen today that are of note. We're going to talk about a software, a proprietary software that we've been building for many years, and it's a very successful, very useful tool. And if you'd like to, as we get into it, call in and ask about a particular stock to see how it screens in our software or write in on the email, you're more than welcome to. Again, the email is peter@inblackandwhites.com. We're also going to post some interesting stuff on the blog today, maybe even related to a trial of our software. So if it's something that's of interest to you, we're going to probably post that on the blog after the show, and you want to make sure that you go on the blog and download it so you can try out this powerful tool. And you'll learn more about it as we get into today's program. But let me start out by introducing my guest, Joseph Fitzgerald. Joe's worked in numerous capacities in the securities industry over the last 17 years, having gained broad experience at several broker-dealers, working with high net worth and private clients, as well as in the institutional sales arena. Joe brings a rare insight to the company in both the needs of small and large investors alike. And his knowledge has been instrumental in Fusion Analytics building this software program that he is so close to, and he's going to explain why. He's a member of the Norman Vincent Peale Foundation and the St. Vincent de Paul Foundation, and he got his Bachelor of Science of Finance at Marist College. And the last thing I'll say is that he's a lifelong diehard Jets fan, and I don't even know how to respond to that. But Joe, welcome to the program.
Peter, thank you very, very much for having me. And please, anybody who's a Patriot fan out there, don't hold it against me. But I am a lifelong Jet fan, and I bleed green. But Peter, thanks again for having me on the program.
Yeah, my pleasure. So, you know, let's just go back in time, Joe. We started a software program, and I've been with the company now. I'm in my sixth year, and the software has evolved many times for the better. But take me back in history and talk about what exactly, when we talk about the software, what is it and how it came about?
It's a great question, and I always love to bring it back to when I was a retail broker I was working in the World Trade Center for a retail brokerage arm that was a bunch of guys from Oppenheimer. And a long story short, we met a gentleman by the name of Kevin Lane who was doing technical quantitative work at the time. He was like basically a one-man shop. He had a few guys around him at a firm called Technomentals Research Group. And to make a long story short, we started to buy Kevin's technical research as an overlay because we were retail brokers. No disrespect to retail brokers, but we tend to fall in love with stories and we never know how to exit a name. And right now I'm speaking specifically about equity. So we would fall in love with a story. Insiders were buying a what have you. We'd own the stock at 20 and all of a sudden it would go to 18 and then 16 and then 14. And then the old adage was don't frown, average down. And I was literally seeing people blow up their books, including myself back in the 90s. And Kevin really came in and basically I got to know him personally, of course, in 1999. we became best friends. But what I found was, is he was very unemotional. He was objective. He had no axe to grind. So when I came to him and I said, we own WorldCom, and we own, the firm owns a ton of WorldCom at the time, he said, Joe, he said, Fitzy, listen, tell your guys to get out of WorldCom if it breaks X. And I think at the time it was $29 or $28, and Bernie Ebbers was buying the stock, and he was the golden cowboy on the Business Week article, and everybody loved it. But at the time, Kevin was seeing deterioration. And I bring up WorldCom because obviously we know what happened to WorldCom, and I don't say it to anybody out there to impress you, but to impress upon you that this guy had such an influence in my brain and the way we, way I managed money for the firm at the time that I was with. I was like, this guy shoots straight, and there's no emotion. Like, when he calls me up and says, own this or sell this or what have you, it was almost like I was blown away by how unemotional he was to his process. And fast forward, in 2001, I knew I was going to go work with Kevin because he was putting out institutional research at the time, technical quantitative. He was making some very, very big calls. And again, folks, I don't say this to impress you, but to impress upon you that he was doing the, you know, the TV circuit at the time. He was on every week. People loved him. And he was just basically shooting straight. And he was very simple and succinct. And he had a great, great way that he put pictures, he put charts up in a research PDF, if you will, and in three or four pages, he was simple and succinct and gave you reasons why to own a stock and technical, you know, entry and exit points, and or why to sell a stock. And at that point, obviously, we know in 2000, 2001, 2002 what happened. I was blown away. So with that said, Fusion IQ became a process where Kevin said to himself, I want to find a way to create a cohesive system to screen U.S. stocks. That's how he started. Let me look at U.S. stocks and sectors. And I want to get very granular if I need to, obviously, but an overall system that will blend technical and quantitative metrics along with the fundamental side. Pete, I'm going to take a step back. When we started, when he started building Fusion IQ in 02, we would present to institutional customers. And at the time, they were either technically derived in terms of their investment process or they were fundamentally derived in their investment process. And at the time, I remember us calling, you know, shops from managing a few hundred million to billions of dollars, and we would say we're technically quantitative, and they would say we're fundamentally based, and they would think we were basically voodoo. So there was no cohesiveness between technical and fundamental analysis, and that's where Kevin said, there's got to be a way to find a system that I can build to cohesively bring both disciplines in a very cohesive and simple way to present it. So we went back to, for example, we saw in our system gold was really performing well in 02, 03, and Kevin's on the record about getting in gold very early. Fusion IQ at the time was called TechuRank, and it was, we were using internally, and we were noticing, for example, the energy sector. A lot of names in the oil and gas and oil service sector, people were, it was under-owned in the S&P at the time, but in our system, which we'll get into, it was showing us a lot of buy signals and a lot of high rankings, and it got us into those. And the long story short was we saw a lot of folks start to embrace the technology, and over the last, especially over the last 4 or 5 years, we've really refined it. Fusion IQ is the name of the tool. A lot of asset advisors, asset managers, and high net worth people that manage their own money use it, and they use it for two reasons, Pete. They use it for a risk management overlay, which means they'll create portfolios and watch lists, and they'll look for changes in timing signals of the buy and sell signals of the decile classes, you know, moving up or down. And they also use it as a great idea generation tool. That's what a lot of folks that manage money at other firms use us for, is, again, a great risk management overlay and a great idea generation tool. Again, it's not the holy grail, but it is a very cohesive system that seems to be very, very timely.
And that's cool. And so now you take a job, you're working with Kevin, you build, you decide to make this software that uses all of this. I mean, how are you able to take ideas, you know, based on, you know, quantitative thoughts and turn it into a software that's going to tell you how to buy or sell a stock?
It's a great question, and I'm sure Kevin, when you've had him on in the past, he's a very brilliant guy, and I'll say that. He won't say it, but I will say it. And anybody, we all work around him, we know it with his brilliance. What the answer to the question is, no real simple answer, but the best I can say is he wanted to see names, and I'm going to really quickly, if it's okay, talk about the system if we have some time.
Yeah, yeah, of course.
It's all stocks are ranked from a 0 to 100 scale. It's very similar to IBD, but it's not, because it's very intuitive and I think it's more timely. But we're ranking things on a technical and fundamental basis. We have a master score, which ranks from 0 to 100. The master score is made up of the technical score and the fundamental score, and it has a weighting of 70-30 because we're technicians, and we do believe that any technical events will always precede any fundamental events, so we're really technically weighted, but you can sort them any way you'd like. And Kevin wanted to see what high-ranked names did. So we found, after testing, that, for example, names with a master score of 70 or higher generally would outperform going forward. And let's just use the S&P 500 as a benchmark. And we found names that, you know, ranked 40 to 70 generally performed in line with the market, and names under 40, for example, would generally underperform. And we're in the process of backtesting a bunch, and we can make those available once they're all available to us. But what we found is higher-ranked name stocks do better. With that said, Kevin has created these buy and sell signals. And if you're in the site, folks, obviously Pete's going to put it up on his blog later. You can have a trial of it, of course. But there's multiple trading screens, and one of them is called recent timing signals. And it's probably one of our featured products. People love it. And what it does is it just takes a technical algorithms. There's many in there, but no fundamental scores make up the technical buy and sell signals. And what it helps you do is enter and exit stocks at appropriate times. Are we going to catch every bottom and every top? Absolutely not. But what Kevin's tried to do, and he's really done it well, and put it into this cohesive system, is try to keep you in the meat of a move, whether it's up or down. And originally we had buy, sell, and neutral signals, which we've eliminated the neutral signal over the last 2 years because we found in sideways tapes, for example, Pete, you may get neutral signals, and Kevin calls them itchy, or it gets kind of itchy where you get a buy, neutral. We've eliminated those, and now they're strict buy and sell signals. So every instrument in the system, when you pull up a stock, you can go back a number of years and see where the buy and sell signals were created. And again, they're all technically derived. There's no emotion to it. I will say this, and we can go into it further later in the call. As a retail broker who became obviously working with Kevin, building the software and running our asset management arm, when you are running money for yourself or others, you can get very emotional, especially at tops and bottoms. And when you get emotional, Pete, you know as well as I do, you're going to get run over because you're going to make very emotional decisions. And a lot of times you'll be puking stocks when you're at the bottom, and you'll be, you know, piling in stocks at the top. And what he's done is really made a cohesive system and taken the emotion out of it. And these buy and sell signals are a testament to basically looking at it, seeing what the scores are showing you. If obviously you have a highly ranked name and you have a buy signal, you got to stay in the name. We'll get into a new feature called IntelliStops a little later on the call as well, which is an intuitive stop loss system, which really helps protect capital and helps you get out of names, for example, when it's the right time.
We're going to get back to that, and I want to talk. Well, you know, maybe what we'll do is at the break, we're going to take a quick break, Joe, but we can get back. Maybe let's just talk about the different criteria that we use to evaluate the technical and the fundamental weightings of stocks and how that evaluates in the stock itself. And we're going to do that in just a minute. You're listening to the In Black and Weitz radio program on Voice America Business.
When it comes to business, you'll find the experts here. Voice America Business Network.
ERISA 408B2, fiduciary standards, safe harbor, fidelity bonds, record keepers, discrimination testing. I am so confused.
Does your 401k plan have more questions than answers? Peter Weitz and his team of 401k experts have a solution. Their on-site service model distinguishes them from other service providers, and they are specialists in 401k costs, regulations, and compliance. If your 401k plan has more questions than answers, then contact Peter at 877-945-2888 or email him at peter@inblackandwhites.com.
Climbing Mount Everest is an amazing feat, and many have died trying to do so. However, more people have died descending Mount Everest than in reaching the summit. Part of the problem may be that people are so focused on reaching their objective that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will do or should be prepared for afterward. Similarly, people are so focused on saving for retirement and reaching retirement that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will encounter once they have actually retired. With one out of every four 65-year-olds today living past the age of 90, you may be retired longer than you are actually working. Have you devised a plan, process, and discipline to ensure that you will not run out of money? If you are not sure what to do, then simply contact Peter Weitz and his retirement team at Fusion Analytics. We help manage human emotions using three proprietary investment techniques. Our job is to evaluate the forces that the typical investor can't see so that wealth is preserved and not lost. Find out more at inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. Email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. In Black and Weitz, we win by not losing.
When it comes to business, you'll find the experts here. Voice America Business Network.
You are listening to In Black and Weitz. To reach Peter Weitz or his guest today, please call 1-866-472-5790. That's 1-866-472-5790. You may also send an email to Peter at inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. Email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. Now, back to this week's program.
Hi, thanks. Welcome back to the program. I'm your host, Peter Weitz. We're joined by Joe Fitzgerald, the managing partner of Fusion IQ. And Fusion IQ is a proprietary software that is used to rank stocks and exchange-traded funds. And prior to the break, Joe was giving us an overview of how the software works and what it's exactly designed to do. And essentially, it uses technical and fundamental analysis to determine the strength of a stock and how it relates to how well we believe, or how well the company believes, the stock is going to do in the marketplace, and also trigger when you might want to buy it and when you might want to sell it. But one of the things I want to talk a little bit about, Joe, is you said that 70% of the weighting of a stock is technical and 30% of the weighting is fundamental. What are some of the technical things that you look at to get that at weighting?
Well, it's a two-part answer, Pete. Number one is Kevin Lane, again, folks, who built Fusion IQ, built a market risk model where he's looking, and on the homepage of Fusion IQ when you log in, you'll see the market risk model on the right side. And what it's looking at is five overall components of trend, breadth, momentum, liquidity, and sentiment. So first, you know, Kevin always uses the adage where he likes to, if you're going to the beach or you're going out in the water for the day, every morning's a different morning, so you want to look at, you know, the overall conditions and what they look like. So we put it in a very cohesive, nice chart. It's called our market risk model, which kind of gives you a gauge on where you should be. Now, to get granular, if you pull up a stock, for example, and we have, as I mentioned, the master score, a technical score, and a fundamental score, the technical score will be made up of, for example, Pete, it's a combination of proprietary technical metrics such as long-term trend score, intermediate trend score, short-term trend score. He's looking at equity money flow score, the underlying equity group money flow score, and there's a couple of bonus scores for short interest adjusted for float, and also institutional ownership, and there's other technical metrics that make up that technical score. And then the fundamental score, the two main ones that we use are a proprietary forward earnings yield and a cash flow metric component. And what we're looking, again, we're firm believers. Folks, you can score any way you want in Fusion IQ. If you want to look at just fundamental scores, for example, there's a lot of ways you can custom screen, look for your universe of names, which is really cool, which we can get into. But right now, we find that a weighting master score of 70% technical and 30% fundamental works in a general sense. So again, we're screening all U.S. stocks, all U.S. ETFs. And what we find, again, we're technically based because we believe the chart will always precede any fundamental event. We find the technical scores being more heavily weighted. We find better returns going forward. Again, we're not going to promise returns, or obviously we manage money for folks as well at the asset management arm. But what we find is technicals will always precede fundamental events, and the technical score weightings of 70 to 30 seem to be the sweet spot. But again, we're continuing to refine the process and back test and see which works better. But folks, you can score any way you'd like, whether it's technical only, fundamental only, or that master score. And again, we're looking for names of 70 or higher on a master score. technical scores, you know, if they're 90 or higher, they could stay that way for quite a long time. Apple's a great example. For many, many years, it stayed 90 or even a 99, pegged technical, and people thought it was overbought, for example, but that wasn't the case. So a lot goes into the technical and fundamental metrics, but again, we lean towards technicals because sometimes by the time you find out why a stock got taken apart, the fundamental event is way, way after the stock is broken down, for example.
So the website, actually, if the listeners want to go to, is www.fusioniqrank.com. That's FusionIQRANK.com. And you'll see some of the things that Joe's talking about. I'm going to post a username and password on the blog after the program, and you'll be able to go in and play around on a trial basis and see what it's talking about. But one of the interesting things that I find, Joe, is, you know, it ranks over 8,000 stocks, over 1,600 ETFs. And when I go in there, the cool part about it is the vast majority of the stocks with the highest weightings I've never heard of.
Yes, it's actually it's an interesting system. We've heard that before, Pete, from a lot of customers. We have subscribers, folks, that are both private investors that manage their own money or portions of their own money. Funny enough, well, more than half of our customer base is actually other advisors at other shops, and they tell us the same thing. They say, you know, I was looking at certain screens, and I'm noticing a lot of names that I never even heard of. And it's a testament to it being a great idea generation tool where, you know, people get enamored with the S&P 500, if you will, or the Russell, or the Dow, what have you. And it's a very narrow universe. Like you said, we screen thousands and thousands of names. And, like, for example, recently we've seen a couple of smaller names go on buy signals, very highly technically ranked rated. Master score is very high, and folks have told us we don't know, we've never seen them before. And it's a great small to mid-cap names, if you will, Pete, where you'll see,
right,
you know, small caps eventually, you know, if they're really good companies, they'll become mid-cap and they'll become large caps. And our goal really is to bring those ideas to you early if we can, conversely get you out of ideas early if they're starting to break down. But there are a lot of small to mid-cap names. I know you had Michael Needleman on the show last week, who helps us. He's the fundamental portion of our Fusion Long Short strategy. And Michael brings a lot of smaller to mid-sized names, not household names, folks, but we all know that once they become a household name and you're reading about it, you know, in the journal, the majority of that move has probably taken place already. So it's a great idea generation tool in that regard. Well, you'll be around a lot of great ideas. And a lot of times, Pete, like you said, there's a lot of small to mid-cap gems, I call them, gems in there, where as long as you use great risk discipline, you know, you can find names early and hopefully stay with them.
Right. So now we've got this great software,
mm-hmm,
and it's built. How is it monitored and updated? Is it when all of a sudden automatically, if information changes, it modifies the software?
It's a great question. We are updating our data on an end of day basis, if that makes sense. We have, you know, providers that at the end of the business today, for example, between usually 4:30 Eastern and 6:30 to 7:30 Eastern, we'll have pulled all the technical and fundamental data changes for today's trading and updated tonight. And you will actually get, you can set email alerts in the system, folks, on names and groups and that sort of thing on your watch lists. And usually between 8:30 and 9 Eastern, Pete, you'll get email alerts knowing that the system is now updated. And if you're doing work the night before, you're ready to go before the next day open. As we evolve the product, we are looking to make it a real-time application. But for most folks out there who are managing money, and if you're not day trading, we don't do it, but end-of-day data seems to work. But we are updating every day at the end of the day. And for a lot of institutional accounts, we'll run, you know, live screens intraday and alert them at changes in their names. But for right now, Fusion IQ, end-of-day data, pull everything in, and usually by 8, like between 8 and 9 Eastern, you're ready to go for the next morning. So you'll have all the new trading screens, all the new buy signals, all the new sell signals, the new IntelliStop value is created. So again, end-of-day data.
And so let's briefly get into exactly, we implemented this new thing called IntelliStop. So we might have to break before we get through it all, but mm-hmm, explain to me what an IntelliStop is and how it's useful as a tool inside of this software.
Very long story short, it's a very smart stop loss mechanism, and it's adjusted for beta. So obviously Apple trades different than GE does in terms of volatility. It's adjusted for that, but at the end of the day, every day, you can punch in, for example, a snapshot on Apple. And to the right, you'll see an IntelliStop band, folks. When you're looking at the chart, and just so you know, not to get too off tangent, but two nights a month, we have a Fusion IQ strategy session webinar. The next one is tomorrow night at 8 Eastern. We have them every other Wednesday night. We teach you how to use the tool. So I urge you, if you're interested, get in touch with Pete. We'll get you an invite out. But you can see on the chart when you pull it up, there's a band. And what we're looking at is, Kevin always talked about two thought disciplines in terms of selling a stock. There's a trading stop, if you will, Pete, where if you're looking to trade around a position or at alpha and that sort of thing, you have a very tight trading stop, and then there's the investment stop, we call it, or a line in the sand stop, where no matter what's happening, you're out of this name once it breaks this. And I've, going back a decade with Kevin, I've seen him say, here's the trading stop, here's the line in the sand stop. So what he's been able to do is really cohesively bring it into the system. So every night, you know, folks, it's updated where Apple's stop losses, for example. I'm looking at Apple right now, and the IntelliStop is $84.74. And that seems a little far, but also it's been on a buy signal, just so we know, fully disclosed, since March 25th of this year. And you'll notice that, you know, Apple has pulled back recently, but when you're looking at a chart of Apple in Fusion IQ, there's a band. There's an upper band and a lower band. And you could see where the IntelliStop, you know, it kept you in. Sometimes names run, Pete. Obviously, we know this. And it will start to pull back, and people will decide to sell it because it's rolling over. Kevin always talks about the term rolling over. We hate it. But the IntelliStop will keep you in the stock generally and eliminate that whippiness, if you will. But every night it is updated, and you will have that. You can have that email alerted to you and know where that stop loss is. And it just seems to me, and I'll speak not for ourselves, but for a lot of other advisors that use us in their investment daily their process on a daily basis, that that thing has saved them a fortune, especially in 08. I will say that.
And that's pretty cool, a pretty cool piece of the tool. And so who sets that IntelliStop? I do when I use the tool, or is that something you guys monitor?
We monitor it. It's updated every night. So when you log into Fusion IQ, you will see, an upper left-hand corner of Apple. And again, folks, on a webinar tomorrow night, you could see this with us, and we can give you a trial. You'll be able to see where the buy signal was. You can quickly add it to your watch list. And in their big red box, it's pretty blatant, upper left-hand corner, there is a price. And that's technically derived every night. That score is updated on a daily basis. So you can... You know, we're updating it for you and continuing to change that IntelliStop value, because it's going to, you know, based on what the stock does, it's going to change. You could be alerted by logging in, email alerts, that sort of thing. So a lot of folks have said that they'll just set alerts, and if they see changes, they'll be alerted to it right away, and they'll adjust their stops accordingly. But it's a very cool feature because it's unbiased, it's unemotional. It tells you where it is. Now, is it going to work 10 out of 10 times? Absolutely not. But is it going to work more than often than not? It will. Because we've seen it personally with the way we manage money, and we've seen it with other folks that manage a lot more money than we do, and they've said it's been very, very helpful as that risk management overlay that we talk about.
And that's when we get back from the break, Joe. I want to talk about this tool's been getting a lot of traction from some of the major players, some of the major wirehouses in the market. And I want to talk a little bit about how they're using it and what they did to vet the validity of this product. And we're going to do that when we get back from the break. You're listening to the In Black and Whites radio program on the Voice America Business Network.
From the boardroom to you, Voice America Business Network.
Climbing Mount Everest is an amazing feat, and many have died trying to do so. However, more people have died descending Mount Everest than in reaching the summit. Part of the problem may be that people are so focused on reaching their objective that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will do or should be prepared for afterward. Similarly, people are so focused on saving for retirement and reaching retirement that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will encounter once they have actually retired. With one out of every four 65-year-olds today living past the age of 90, you may be retired longer than you are actually working. Have you devised a plan, process, and discipline to ensure that you will not run out of money? If you are not sure what to do, then simply contact Peter Weitz and his retirement team at Fusion Analytics. We help manage human emotions using three proprietary investment techniques. Our job is to evaluate the forces that the typical investor can't see so that wealth is preserved and not lost. Find out more at inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. Email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. In Black and Weitz, we win by not losing.
ERISA 408B2, fiduciary standards, safe harbor, fidelity bonds, record keepers, discrimination testing. I am so confused.
Does your 401k plan have more questions than answers? Peter Weitz and his team of 401k experts have a solution. Their on-site service model distinguishes them from other service providers, and they are specialists in 401k costs, regulations, and compliance. If your 401k plan has more questions than answers, then contact Peter at 877-945-2888 or email him at peter@inblackandwhites.com.
Voice America Business Network. The bottom line in business.
You are listening to In Black and Weitz. To reach Peter Weitz or his guest today, please call 1-866-472-5790. That's 1-866-472-5790. You may also send an email to peter@inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. Email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. Now, back to this week's program.
Hi, thanks. Welcome back to the program. We're joined today by Joe Fitzgerald, the Managing Director of Fusion IQ. And prior to the break, we were talking pretty extensively about the software that Joe manages, the Fusion IQ software, which you can look up at www.fusioniqrank.com. And essentially what we're trying to accomplish here is having the ability to make the most amount of money by taking emotion out of the mix. And as investors, we typically, and we've talked about this many times on the show, we typically start a sentence out with "I think," and we never really have a reason as to why we make the decisions. You know, my broker told me to do it. I don't know why I bought this. I should sell it now. And they always typically do one thing. They sell it at the lowest point after they bought it at the highest point. And we're all guilty of that. So this software is designed to help take the emotion out of that. And, you know, Joe, before we get in, I think about the emotion. It reminds me of a quote. When I think about quotes, you know, I'm thinking what the typical investor has in mind. And if they've made mistakes and they've squandered away some of the savings that they've had, they're always, you know, thinking, how are they going to survive? And the quote is, "No problem, just leave me the keys to the liquor cabinet." And it seems to be a nice way to solve the problem, right? But it really doesn't. And I'm going to tell you, that quote came from the well-known TV character Alf, otherwise known as Gordon Shumway, who I know you're very fond of.
Very fond of Gordon Shumway.
Yeah. And Gordon and Alf's way of handling problems and his emotions were to just go straight to the liquor cabinet. And so we're trying to avoid that here with this software. But in any event, in any event, I want to go back to that, Joe. Again, is so we're taking the emotion out, and we're sort of getting some traction with this software. And I know a major wirehouse has taken a look at it. What exactly are they doing to vet the validity of this?
Great point. Just to your point about emotion and investing, you know, folks, not to sound like a broken record, but we talk about it internally all the time, and I've learned this from Kevin over the course of the last 10 to 12 years. You know, when markets are making tops or bottoms is when people are making the most unemotional decisions ever. And what we're trying to do is get you to be in the zone, and, you know, making money is most important, but really protecting it is just as important. I mean, Kevin said before, you know, you could take a shot to the arm, a bullet to the arm or a bullet to the foot or leg, what have you, but you can't take one to the head. I mean, how many times, Pete, do we hear in 08, for example, people calling us up saying that they, you know, they were obliterated that year and they were down half their money. Now you got to double your money just to get back even. And we see it all the time, and it's not easy. It's a process. It's never an event. But what we're trying to do with IQ is to really take the emotion out of buying and selling stocks. And again, it's not going to be 10 for 10, but a lot of times if you have statistical evidence backed up in your favor to make a trade or get out of a trade, you know, as long as the risk reward is in your favor, you got to place that trade. And again, you know, there'll be times where we'll buy a stock and we'll immediately get stopped out of it. That's what a risk discipline is. But we're not afraid to go back into it, that's for sure. In answer to your question about the wirehouses, there are a number of advisors that we use at different wirehouses that use Fusion IQ in their daily process. And one of them, for example, for the last 2 years has been using their household name. And what they found was this, there was pockets of advisors both here in New York and in Connecticut that were using at the time, and they still do, Pete, Fusion IQ as an overlay to their investment process. So I'll give you an example. What they did specifically was they loved the research that their shop was putting out. They would look for the number one buy-rated recommendations from their research analysts. Then they would overlay Fusion IQ, and they would wait for a Fusion IQ buy signal. And then they would own the stock. And then if there was a Fusion IQ sell signal, they would sell the stock. So they would use the buy and sell signals as an overlay to their main research that they liked. And what they found was that the returns were not good. They were great. And I don't say, you know, I will beat my chest because I believe in the product. I know it's a great product. But they, by using it as an overlay for a couple of years with real money, they were using it as, you know, running real money with it, they found that they significantly outperformed. So with that said, they went to the heads of wealth management at the group. They know Fusion IQ well. They said, this product is unbelievable, and we need us, you know, we need to use it more in our process. So what they decided to do was just take Fusion IQ as a standalone before using it as the layover of how they're using it internally. They said, we want to know how the buy and sell signals work. So Pete, what they did was they asked us for 15 years of S&P data. We took the S&P 500. We went back 15 years, and we gave them every buy and sell signal in the system at the time. It turned out to be, I think, 1,000 or 1,015 names in the S&P over that time, with additions and deletions, if you will. And what they found in their back test, we didn't do the back test, they did. They just came back a couple of months ago and told us that we significantly outperformed the S&P 500. Significant. They were looking for maybe a 2 or 3% better to really embrace the product internally and create some products around it, and we blew that away. I'll be glad to share that with you. I won't go into too much detail, but it was a unbelievable return that they saw versus the S&P on just the buy and sell signal. So as a standalone product, you know, we've had outside people testing it, and they find that it's a very, very useful tool. And Pete, what I asked the quant at that shop specifically when he gave us the results about 7 or 8 weeks ago was I asked him if there's anything good or bad or indifferent. What really stuck, what really, you know, jumped out at you when you did this? And what he said to me was, quote, the timeliness of the system. And I said, what do you mean by that? And he said, the timeliness of the buy and sell signals was unbelievable. He said, in fact, at peaks and troughs, you guys outperformed by like 80% or 79%. Like, for example, in 02, I think, off the lows, or maybe it was off the 07, off the 09 lows. But what he said was the timeliness of the buy and sell signals was what really raised his eyebrow. Because I want to know good, bad, or indifferent, how people like this product and how they embrace it. And we always tell folks, send us your feedback. Kevin and I and Craig and other guys that are managing Fusion IQ read every morsel of feedback we get. But this quant group out of this major wirehouse has told us that the timeliness of the signals was what really impressed them. And most importantly is, like, if you waited a couple of days, for example, Pete, if a buy signal happens last night, for example, and you waited 3 days, it eroded all of those great gains. So he said the timeliness of the buy and sells in that 15-year backtest was what really stood out. And we're still obviously talking to them and other folks. And with that said, they had brought us in, Kevin, to present to 75 or 80 of their brokers right after that backtest. And we're continuing to work with both small advisories and large ones to show them how Fusion IQ will not replace their investment process, but be a great overlay to their investment process. And I stress that to you folks. We're not trying to reinvent the wheel. A lot of folks that manage money know what they're doing. We know they're smart. They've gotten to where they are because they're smart. We're not trying to replace their process. We're just trying to be a piece, a tool in their chest, if you will, as a layover strategy to whatever their core vision is in terms of how they manage money. But we've gotten very good returns and very good feedback. And, of course, we're continuing to refine our process. And hopefully within a couple of years, Fusion IQ will be a household name. That's the goal.
And let me ask you this question, too, because we worked on this for a while. Inside of the software, there's also some charting mm-hmm. tools that are available. Can you briefly touch on sort of what that means and what you can do with it?
Sure. In the version of Fusion IQ, in the upper right-hand corner, there's a snapshot rank where you can pull up any symbol in the system. And you'll get a quick, you can pull up a, you know, candlestick-type charts and what have you. You can get very granular. We have an advanced charting application, which we're actually working on updating right now. But there's a lot you can do with the advanced charting that's available at a higher price point to folks. There's both an investor version, Pete, and a trader version. And the trader version gives you everything, including IntelliStops. But the technical, the charting in the system is really good. And again, we're technicians at heart. Kevin's a technician at heart, so he appreciates being able to get very granular with his technical indicators. So there is an advanced charting application. I won't get into too much detail about it, but there are a lot of overlays you can put in there. But the simple chart in Fusion IQ is very simple. You can put some overlays. You can go back, you know, daily, 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, 6 years, 6 months, 1 year, 2 year, 3 year, 5 year. And it's a very simple, what we want to do is keep this simple for folks. We don't want to make it where you have to, you know, go through pages and pages of information. In the snapshot rank, you'll see the stock, you'll see the group it's in, you'll see the description, you'll have a very clear, concise what group it's in, the master score, the technical score, the fundamental score. We give you short-term, intermediate-term, long-term scores, money flow scores, group money flow scores. I may be boring some folks out there, but we really put it in a very, very nice picture for you so you could see it right in one screen. And then, of course, we have the buy and sell signals and the IntelliStops plotted on the charts in Fusion IQ, which are extremely, extremely helpful is the word we're getting back. But again, we keep it simple in Fusion IQ, but then in one of the tabs you can get into advanced charting, where if you appreciate technicals, you can get very granular and you can get all the indicators you're looking for.
And that's pretty cool. And, you know, I'm looking, I'm just kind of playing around with it right now. And it just so that some of the, you know, the listeners know, the stocks are categorized within how they rank overall in the entire portfolio of over 8,000 stocks. But they can also be categorized by a certain sector and then subgroups within that sector. So you can go into basic materials, for example, and then you can subgroup it by chemicals, energies, or metals and mining. And consumer goods, it's broken into automotive, consumer durables, non-durables, food and beverage, and tobacco. And so you can it goes into many, many different layers by which you can look at it. And I think that's what makes it pretty powerful. When we get back from the break, Joe, I want to just go through a couple of examples of how the tool works, how it comes, what sort of leads up to it becoming a buy signal, and then how you kind of ride it out through that period of time. And we're going to do that when we get back from the break. You're listening to the In Black and Whites radio program on Voice America Business.
Voice America Business Network, the bottom line in business.
ERISA 408B2, fiduciary standards, safe harbor, fidelity bonds, record keepers, discrimination testing. I am so confused.
Does your 401k plan have more questions than answers? Peter Weitz and his team of 401k experts have a solution. Their on-site service model distinguishes them from other service providers, and they are specialists in 401k costs, regulations, and compliance. If your 401k plan has more questions than answers, then contact Peter at 877-945-2888 or email him at peter@inblackandwhites.com.
Climbing Mount Everest is an amazing feat, and many have died trying to do so. However, more people have died descending Mount Everest than in reaching the summit. Part of the problem may be that people are so focused on reaching their objective that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will do or should be prepared for afterward. Similarly, people are so focused on saving for retirement and reaching retirement that they fail to plan appropriately for what they will encounter once they have actually retired. With one out of every four 65-year-olds today living past the age of 90, you may be retired longer than you are actually working. Have you devised a plan, process, and discipline to ensure that you will not run out of money? If you are not sure what to do, then simply contact Peter Weitz and his retirement team at Fusion Analytics. We help manage human emotions using three proprietary investment techniques. Our job is to evaluate the forces that the typical investor can't see so that wealth is preserved and not lost. Find out more at inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. In Black and Whites, we win by not losing.
The business community's first choice in Internet Talk Radio, Voice America Business Network.
You are listening to In Black and Whites. To reach Peter Weitz or his guest today, please call 1-866-472-5790. That's 1-866-472-5790. You may also send an email to Peter at inblackandwhites.com. Weitz is spelled W-E-I-T-Z. Email Peter at inblackandwhites.com. Now, back to this week's program.
Hi, thanks. Welcome back to the program. I'm your host, Peter Weitz. We're joined today by Joe Fitzgerald, the managing director of Fusion IQ. And we've been talking the whole show about the power of a software that Joe and his team has developed that helps to screen stocks and ETFs to determine when you should buy them, when you should sell them, and to kind of take the emotion out of all of that. And, you know, Joe, during the break, and I just checked, we got an email from a listener who asked the following question: is does your software rank by sector, and how is that sector ranking get adjusted, and can stocks perform better in certain sectors but not affect the weighting of that sector?
It's a great question. The short answer is yes, of course. There's when you log into Fusion IQ, there are five tabs across the top, and in the first tab is called rankings, where you can drill down to equity rankings, sector rankings, group rankings, subgroup rankings, ETF rankings, and then we put up a popular indices tab just so you can kind of quickly on the fly see how every indice is ranked, and you can drill down. For example, in sectors, when you go into the sector rankings, you can see it lists the nine sectors. Utilities right now is number one. But the way we do it, folks, is once you click that sector rankings tab, we bring up a table where it gives you the name of the sector, the stock count, the number of names in that sector. It gives you the master score, the technical score, the fundamental score. A cool feature based on our buy and sell signals is it gives you the number of new buys in that group, a number of new sells in that group. And what we find is folks that are managing money for themselves or for others or both will use this tool to kind of drill down, and they'll say, all right, utilities are outperforming. You can quickly, each sector is a hyperlink. You can drill into that group and see what the best names are in the group. You can quickly see, for example, in the utilities, you have UTL and UGI, PEG, TRP, and it'll sort it from the highest master score, technical score, down. So, Pete, it's a very great way for if you're managing money, again, for others or for yourself, you can quickly drill down and say, all right, utilities, what names in the utilities do they like? So you can quickly see the highest ranked names. You can quickly see the lowest ranked names. And a lot of folks have told us that they use it for pair trades. They'll go long the best names and short the worst names and that sort. But it's a situation where you can get very granular. Some folks don't, but most folks that do manage money use it because they want to really get granular and see where the strength is in these sectors. And again, as Pete mentioned before, you can get into subgroups. For example, for the utilities group, you can go into diversified utilities, electric utilities, foreign utilities, gas utilities, water utilities. These are all drop-downs available, folks, that you'll be able to, on the fly, very quickly, in a couple of seconds, pull up the best and worst-ranked names in those groups. Pete, to your second point, there is a lot of times where there'll be outliers where names in the groups will be, maybe they'll be low ranked, but they're in a strong group and they're kind of, going with the trend, if you will, and they're being brought up, all tides rise or all tides, obviously lower. But what we're finding is, and I'll give a great example. If you have a group that maybe has been decimated, for example, the banks back in 08, where you see a stock go from a 90 rank all the way down to a 10 rank, and people will say, well, now it's oversold, isn't it? Not necessarily. What we're looking for, if a name gets beaten up, for example, is, A, we won't own it, of course, until we start to see the ratings or the rankings of the master technical and fundamental score start to increase. Again, we believe that the technical score will go first, and it will kind of drive the master and master score. But what we find is names that, for example, went from a 90 to a 10, Pete, all of a sudden will start to get back into the 20 decile class, then go to a 30. We're looking for names like that that may have been really beaten up, that all of a sudden are starting to move now aggressively north through the master scores, 10, 20, 30, 40, in conjunction with a buy signal. And that will generally show us that maybe it's time to own the stock again. And I know I'm getting a little off tangent, but it's a very, very cool tool where you can drill down very quickly in groups, utilities, subgroups, see the best names, the worst names, and then the outliers in those groups, the really, really good names in those groups and the worst names, and you can get really, really detailed. And again, look for the signals and the IntelliStops to help you manage that risk.
And interestingly enough, and I'm just playing around with the software myself, mm-hmm. because every time I go on it, I'm fascinated. But the, mm-hmm. you know, one of the highest ranking stocks mm-hmm. on the software right now is a company called Pacific Airport Group, and I've never heard of them, like I mentioned earlier. And it says here, the company is engaged in the operation, management, and development of airport facilities in the Pacific and central regions of Mexico. So here's some rare stock that, you know, who knows, you know, who would have ever thought to right. that it existed, right?
Yep.
And if you look at the chart, yep. and this is the power of the tool, on yep. January 16th of this year, you guys put a buy signal on it
yep.
at about $51.50 a share.
Mm-hmm.
As of yesterday, it closed at, you know, around 68.
And change.
Yeah, 67 and change. So, mm-hmm. in you know, basically, there's a 40% gain mm-hmm. in the first 6 months of this year using the software as a tool. I mean, that's amazing.
It is, and it gets back to your point where a lot of folks are saying, Jesus, I'm seeing names that I've never seen before. Like, I've never seen these names before. Where have they been? And that's the beauty of having a tool in your arsenal is to say, all right, nobody has a monopoly on all the great ideas, and you could trade the S&P 500, you could trade the NASDAQ 100, you could trade the Dow 30. But again, those names have already made the moves, in our opinion. And again, we're not really – we're looking for to find gems, and there's a lot of them out there. And Pacific Airport Group is a great example, PAC. Nobody knows that name hardly is my bet. And, you know, as you said, since January, the stock's been on a buy signal. It has a master score of an 82, a technical score of a 100. Fundamental score is still very weak. It's still a 40. That's probably improved. And again, you know, this fundamental data is generally updated monthly and mostly quarterly, if you will. That's why we believe the fundamentals will lag the technicals. But this is a great example, Pete, of a name that who the hell knew it? And all of a sudden, you know, if you're following IQ, not to pat ourselves on the back, but I will, it puts you in the stock and kept you in the stock. And that's what we're looking to do. We're trying to keep you in the meat of a move, folks, up or down. And again, you can look at these on 1 year, 2 year, 3 year. You can go back as far as you want. As long as we have trading history on a stock, you'll be able to see where the buy and sell signals came in. Again, that's an unemotional, unbiased technical opinion, again, only. And I'm going to also pat ourselves on the back for IntelliStops, because that IntelliStop value, if you look at the chart, Pete, you can see there's a band, again, that red, those two red lines. There were times where, since January, this stock has actually pulled back, right? It peaked, and then it pulled back and based and went again. And then it got cracked. It looked like it got cracked. It just pulled back. It was in a healthy uptrend. This IntelliStop value, which is continuing to update daily, just continue to adjust, but it never got you out of the stock. It kept you in those names. So, for example, when it went to 65 and then pulled all the way back to 61, I know a lot of folks use that term, oh, it's rolling over, it's time to get out. You got to take the emotion out of it, and that's what we're able to do with IntelliStop. And, yeah, it's kept you in that name. Like you said, Pacific Airport Group, who knew?
And it's a right, very, and my argument to that is when you talk about taking the emotion out,
mm-hmm.
I just made 40% on something I know nothing about, and that's what's going to make an investor very happy.
Very, very good point. I couldn't have said it any better. That is absolutely the truth, because a lot of times, if you get 20% or so or 25%, I've seen brokers, I've seen advisors that I've worked with, I've seen myself do it, where you make 20% in a name and all of a sudden you think you're the next best thing and you
right.
skip into sell that stock. And meanwhile, that was just the beginning of the move, you know. So what we're trying to do is keep you in names, again, as long as we can, and get you out of names early. But that unemotional part of that buy and sell signal is really what we're excited about at Fusion IQ, because again, we have no axe to grind. And, you know, there were times where PAC looked like it was pulling back, but it wasn't violating anything technically. It was just doing a healthy pullback. Stocks can't go straight up. And it digested some of the gains and it continued its momentum upward, and it's kept in the name, which is good to see.
Yeah, that's amazing. And Joe, I want to thank you so much for being on today's program. A couple of things I want to throw out there. Number one, please make sure you go to my blog today. I'm going to post some stuff on Joe's software and ways you can go online and test it out for yourself. The website for the software itself is www.fusioniqrank. That's FusionIQRank.com. and you can see all of this, this amazing tool for yourself. Joe, thanks for being on the program.
Peter, very much appreciated. Thank you for having us on, and everybody have a great rest of your week and a good 4th of July.
Yeah, 4th of July. And next week on the show, I've got a really interesting guest. I have a former head of cybersecurity for the Department of Homeland Security, and we're going to be talking about data breaches. And it's been interesting. You've been reading in the paper Target and some other companies about how well with this internet rage is your data protected, and what are some of the things you can do if you're into e-commerce. What can you do to protect yourselves and, more importantly, protect the data of your clientele? And for us here in the financial services industry, that's certainly something that we think about on a regular and frequent basis. Again, thanks to my guest, Joe Fitzgerald from Fusion IQ. Make sure you check out his software. It's certainly amazing. Send me any questions and comments you have about how to use the software or a tool. Is if you want to find out about a stock, we'll tell you what we think. My email is peter@inblackandwhites.com. And you can find me on my blog at In Black and Whites. I'll be posting all about the Fusion IQ software shortly after today's program. Joe, appreciate you being on the show. Everyone have a wonderful holiday and make it a great week. You're listening to the In Black and Whites radio program on the Voice America Business Network.
Thank you again for tuning in to In Black and Whites. Please join your host, Peter Weitz, again next Tuesday at 10 a.m. Eastern Time and 7 a.m. Pacific Time for another edition of the program on the Voice America Business Channel. Have a safe week.